So today on the bench, this is my latest acquisition. It's, how do you call that? Barber pole indicator?
Annunciator.
Hello and welcome back. If you follow the channel, you know that we are enamored with all things Apollo and occasionally Shuttle too. And we also get amused by little things like genuine switches and lights, as nothing is mundane in the Apollo program. We've previously played with the twist-like buttons found in the Houston control room and some genuine LEM indicators. We have another quick one today, the barber pole annunciators. These were prominent on the Apollo control panels. They go gray when something is on and they display a barber pole pattern when it is off. I was always intrigued by these and wondered how they worked and looked in person. There were some on sale recently at RR Auction, not quite Apollo, but Shuttle, which reuse much of the same switch gear. It appears that nobody else than me bet on them, so here they are for your enjoyment.
We have a simple one today. I went on shopping at our auction, and I was the only one to bid on a Space Shuttle instrument panel enunciator, which I think is the same switchery as they use in Apollo. And here they are. So they are, I call them barber pole indicators. You see them on there? I don't think they put them
there. They look, those ones, it's like the stripes in the bottom half, and this one, the stripes in the middle. So looks a little different.
We have them. Where are they? I can't see them.
I think the screws are in a different spot too.
Oh, over there. Yeah.
And those have two stripes. These have three.
Yeah. So they are Shuttle things, but close enough. So I always wondered how they looked. Can you show the back? I can. And
so there's four contacts on the back.
Oh, hold on. I'm not focused on it. There we go.
So there are four contacts on the back. Two looks like the common for coils 1 and 3, and then four is a case ground connection.
Right, so we're thinking that it can flip both up and down.
And then there's a little thing here where it looks like they sealed it after putting nitrogen in.
Yeah, that would make sense. And we suppose it's 28 volts. But
let's start with 110.
I could not find much information about these online. Aircraft Instruments appears to be a small company in Doylestown, Pennsylvania. They still have a minimalist website active. Our indicator is from series 840, but they all look mostly custom.
You want to try it? We haven't tried it yet, so this is all new.
So what do you think, center ground or center hot?
Center ground, I would say. Well, I don't know.
Yeah, could be either.
We have a 50-50 chance.
Okay, hold on. I need to be on it. And we have only, 5 volts on the supply?
All right, let's see what happens.
Nothing. Is the supply on?
Yeah. It is.
Just doesn't do anything. I would change the polarity of the thing.
Okay, let's try center hot.
We had a little bit of motion.
So I think you need a little bit more voltage, maybe. Yeah.
Can't see it.
There we go.
Oh, look at that.
Oh! I didn't see it. Do again.
Bip.
BYP bypass.
Huh.
So you're at 18 volts?
Yeah, it looks like it takes 18 to get it all the way. In the other direction, we get.
Rad. Yeah, so this is definitely Shuttle.
Presumably there's some external components for dampening, because that's really bouncing around a lot.
Because you imagine that in flight, right?
Oh, yeah.
Put it in one position, or maybe you ground it, right? BYP. Okay, that's interesting. Okay, get it to the other position. Rad. So it was center plus there.
Correct.
Sh- Should we try the other one? See if it's any different.
CL?
CL?
OP?
OP.
Wasn't expecting two different messages.
They're not the same color either.
Yeah, just a little different shades of.
And so once they are paired, I think if you shake them, they stay there, right? Yeah, hopefully. Yeah.
Yeah, it looks solid.
Okay.
As opposed to this one where.
Yeah. How much current do you take? Can you switch it to current?
Probably about 15 milliamps. I measured
a bit
over 1k ohms resistance.
So that would be 50 milliamps, that would be 25, so that's around, about 15 or so, 10 to 15. Not much.
I think I got it. So what I did is I wired them across without the center pin connected to anything, and that seems to stabilize it.
You know, Mark, I found what these do.
What do they do?
One is the cabin vent displaying bypass or operational, and then the other one was the radiator showing red.
Wow, how do you know that?
I found a diagram of the shuttle.
So can you find it?
So there's indicators in the shuttle for the cabin vent, either open or closed. That would be the OP and CL that we saw.
Uh-huh.
And then over here.
I think it's over here. Right there.
Yeah. Sorry, I brought the slow computer. You have your radiator controls. And you have indicators for them.
Okay.
So you can have either radiator flow or bypass. So basically you have the switches and then you have the annunciators.
The confirmation.
To tell you how it is.
So flow or bypass.
So that's bypass. The bypass.
So then the other position would be radiator. Yep, radiator.
Oh, okay. And that's very shuttle.
And one position is white, the other is black, so it probably shows normal versus unusual.
Dang, and then if you want to change the legend, you can't, because it's all
closed.
And again, here, open is white, open. And closed is black.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So here is the interior of the shuttle cockpit, and the two panels we are showing were in these highlighted locations. But the same indicators were used in plenty of other places, particularly the open-closed one, which can be used for indicating any valve position. For your nitrogen and oxygen tanks for breathing air here, or for your fuel and oxidizer valves for the orbital maneuvering system rockets, or even for your Star Tracker door positions. By the way, these are some really cool hand drawings of the early shuttle control panels executed in Apollo style. So that's about it for this short and relaxing interlude. I am sure I'll find a use for these indicators somewhere on one of my future setups. Like when I overclock some computer, that would definitely be the rad mode. Anyhow, see you then.